Bern, Switzerland is the site of the Predators' last preseason game as Roman Josi and the Preds square off against SC Bern in the Global Series Challenge. It's the final tune-up before the regular season kicks off on Friday in Prague right here on Bally Sports.
Gave proof through the night. Before training camp,
both Swiss players starting for Nashville. Of course,
heavy Swiss lineup for SC Bern with a lot of sprinkled in former NHL players who have been key pickups for this team. They've played seven games so far in the regular season as SC Bern. As Matthias Ekholm fires from the point with a save made by Philip Lundstrom.
Yeah, Lundstrom could save there. Just hold on, slow down the Predators as you see Johan Lundskog. We had a great conversation with him. He's very forthcoming. He's got 13 new players. This will be the first game that they've actually dressed their entire lineup. A lot of veteran guys, star players, some North American guys that have NHL experience in the game tonight.
Nashville wins the faceoff, but it's taken quickly by Tristan Sherway. A fan favorite, but the play is offside. Sven Berchi just over the line early, and he would have had a good scoring chance.
Yeah, Sven Berchi, as you know, time in Calgary, played for the Portland Winterhawks, and maybe his best time in the NHL. Don't say anything about it.
Towards the midway point of the first period, Predators and Bern, no score, and that's Pekka Rinne hanging out with his wife Erica, son Paulus. Paulus gets his own seat. That's pretty good stuff.
He's sitting on the lap with pregame and Preds royalty, Pekka Rinne. What a great human being, and it's awesome to see him back with the organization in some capacity and here in Bern watching the boys.
It's great to have him along. Great group of gold jerseys across from us. You can see at the top right-hand part of your screen. Barreling ahead is Johansson. Cuts to the middle. Johansson still with the puck. Walling it off. Flips it to the net. Good poke check there by Wutri. DiDomenico lost the battle to McDonough. Now gets it back. He's going to be harassed by Niederreiter. Moved up the other side. Kept in there by Ekholm. Niederreiter behind the net with Ryan Johansson. Johansson and Niederreiter have played together throughout the entire preseason. That raised the crossbar off the deflection. Kiefer Sherwood getting the start with Niederreiter and Johansson. They're still looking for the right fit for that third man. Colton Sissons steals the pass. He'll drive it in on the backhand, floats it to the middle. Broke it up nicely there by Cody Golubev.
But as you see right now, what Bern wants to do, get it up top to Leffel. If they get it to DiDomenico, he's trying to find those backdoor seams.
Under a minute to go, and the penalty to Jeannot for tripping. Penalty whistled at 9:37, so we're past the halfway point of this opening period. And the Bern fans still going strong, and they will not quiet down. Now with speed, Sherway to the middle. A spinning shot, score! With a beautiful shot. A power play goal gives SC Bern the 1-0 lead.
Well, Sherway makes a beautiful pass here. Look at the speed coming up from the defensive zone. You get wide and almost a blind pass, and there's Berchi. Just spins to the backhand. As you can see right here, Sherway finds that spot right there. No look to Berchi. He spins and backhands it, blanket it. You can see just slides a little too far. I think the delay.
Lanes. Lozon fakes the shot. Now fires, and a save made by Rutrick with the glove. He's had a couple of very nice glove saves tonight.
He has, and as you see right now, and this is the bigger ice surface. You get spread out, you get against the boards, but there's nobody in the middle of the ice. Lozon does a good job getting that puck there. It's an easy save for Rutrick. But in North America, you're going to have three gold jerseys right in front of the net, but if you get stuck so far outside, it's a long way to get to that net front.
Face off one back to the captain, Yossi. He'll drive into the net. A backhander, score! Roman Yossi, it is hometown, ties it up. Oh, it's got to be a special moment for number 59.
Roman Yossi, and this might be his least dangerous chance of the period, but this is what he does so well. He gets the puck, and he's just so graceful. He takes it and he cuts. Look at him cut to the net. He finds that lane and just backhands it. He lifts it up, and it just goes under the arm of Buchrik. And just how he handles that, it's a rolling puck. He finds that lane. It's almost like he's waiting. Steps on it, and you can see Wutrick just lifts that arm. He tries to get it back down to cover that hole, but Roman Yossi just guides it in and ties the game at one. Big goal.
Puck loose in the slot. Carrier rushes over, but Bern gets there first. It's cleared by Lindbergh with 30 seconds to go in the frame.
As you mentioned, Bay at there. He's played more games in the Swiss league than any other player in the history. So he's a well-decorated Swiss hockey player in this league and well-respected. And will be the, his last year, he'll be the equipment manager next year.
Xavier hits the trailer. The shot, he scores! It's Leppel. Two-time Olympian Roman Leppel gives Bern the lead back with just 9 seconds left to go in the period. This is not your typical preseason game. Duchesne aggressively knocks a pass down. It's tracked down by Granlund as the next chance starts. Here's Josi out of the penalty box. Stop and go move on Rietzman. Josi creating space for Ekholm. Ekholm floats it across, collision in the crease. Forsberg was pushed into the goalie. Forsberg, a backhander, score! Philip Forsberg ties it up. He was pushed into Wootrieck. Wootrieck was still getting his balance back. And Forsberg collected the pass in the slot and tied it up.
Yeah, that was a tough one. They tried, they finally got to the net. Philip Forsberg gets pushed into Wootrieck. And watch right here. Wootrieck's going to get up, give him a little shove out of the way, and I don't even know if he was able to grab his stick yet. He recognized the puck is coming over right here. He gets pushed in there by his dragon. And then right there, Wootrieck didn't have a great handle on his stick. Caught it late, and Forsberg 3-5 hole. Here it is, too many men. We'll see if we can get a count. Yeah, then we saw one skating off in the middle of the ice, and we saw five players there. So first opportunity here for the Nashville Predators, their first unit on the ice.
So we'll see what they can do with the different ice service, the extra space. They worked on it this morning. Nashville will get another power play opportunity here. They'll go out on a two-man advantage. Granlund right in front for Duchesne. Score! Duchesne didn't waste much time. They were able to get it to him right in the middle. And the Predators, for the first time tonight, take the lead. 34 seconds. Bern needs two. DiDomenico. And a miscommunication. That'll cost some valuable seconds. Jonah had to go back and get it. Here's Leffel. Able to connect. DiDomenico. Got through the traffic. Cahoon, backdoor, score! On the tip! To go. And with the extra attacker, DiDomenico elevated that tip and cuts it to one.
Watch a shifty little play here. DiDomenico just chips it over by Yakov Trenta. He skates by, gets it back to the point, then he goes right to the front of the net and just tips that puck on the way here. You can see that angle on his forehand over the pad of blanket and under the arm. Just hits the bottom of his blocker hand, the back of the net at 13.5. This game just got a little bit interesting, a little bit more interesting here. Still, it's going to be tough. They got to win this face-off and try to get something going quick here. Wootrieck back in the net.
Chris DiDomenico, owner of 6 NHL goals and tons of international goals. He's torn up the Italian league, now trying to do the same in the Swiss league. Nashville gets the face-off. That's important. Duchesne works his way to the net. The feed by Forsberg is cut off. 3 seconds to go. And Nashville trying to work the clock down to zero, and that will do it. A standing ovation. 17,000 plus here at Post Finance Arena. They saw a tremendous showcase tonight. Nashville hangs on for the 4-3 win. Nashville huddling up in victory. There'll be a salute to Roman Josi. 2 goals and an assist. Bern played valiantly. They led it 2-1 at the end of the first period. And listen to this crowd.
Yeah, they put on a great show here. The fans, the city of Bern, SC Bern was such a great host. And we were got ourselves treated to a great hockey game here that, you know, was more than just a hockey game to a lot of these fans here in Switzerland. Nino Niederreiter, Roman Josi. very dear to their hearts. And there you can see the wall there.
So a ceremony at center ice. Here are your three stars of the game.
Wonder if we'll see number 59 in there.
Three stars of the game presented by Adidas. The third star from Team SC Bern, Mitten on the Trees with number 13,
Gutrick, an outstanding performance. Under pressure all night, made a lot of excellent saves to keep his team in the game.
Yep, well deserved.
The second star from the Nashville Predators, number 22, number 22, Nino.
Nino Niederreiter with the second star.
He's loud. He might have got the hometown benefit there, I think, but it's awesome to see him recognized by the fans here as well.
And everybody knows who number one is.
Yep.
Again from the Nashville Predators, number 59,
just a beautiful celebration. The picture Roman Josi is a youngster coming to watch SC Bern play. He knew how to get the free tickets.
Some of the Ricola candies outside the front to help get into the building to watch the game. A player here, obviously drafted by the Nashville Predators, one of the best players in the league, and just an incredible story. And now he's a part owner of the team, and to see him come back and get to experience this with former teammates, friends, family, it's been unbelievable.
And the celebratory handshake. Roman Josi shaking hands with his countrymen. The Predators win it 4-3. What a night of hockey as we look ahead to the NHL season. Thanks for joining us for the NHL Global Series.
Well, Hal, what an amazing sight to see, especially with Roman Josi getting the first star. That just has to be an incredible moment for him.
Oh, it was awesome. A Roman Josi story.
It was.
It was amazing. What an atmosphere there in that building.